Paz, mis hermanos. Buenos días. Praise the Lord, everyone. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us once again. We hope and pray that everyone is doing well. We've been hearing good reports of the brethren gathering at home and worshiping and becoming consecrated more and more so with their families, which is exactly what I believe the Lord wants to do. Hermanos, hemos escuchado hermosos reportes que ustedes han estado orando como familias, ayunando, y eso es hermosísimo. Y yo creo que el Señor en estos días quiere que nosotros sigamos haciendo eso. Amén. Hermanos, ahí donde están sentados o de pie, yo quisiera que ustedes se acerquen conmigo a la presencia de Dios. Amén. Vamos a hacer esto, vamos a levantar las manos y vamos a levantar nuestras voces porque el Señor es bueno. Amén. Help me pray. And if you would feel so free to do so with me, why don't you go and lift up your hands and lift up your voices. Señor Jesucristo, Padre eterno, Dios de los cielos, te adoramos, te glorificamos, te exaltamos, Señor, porque tú eres nuestro Rey, nuestro sacerdote altísimo. You are our King, Lord, that comes quickly, and our High Priest, Lord, intervenes, Lord, perpetually for your children. Right now, Heavenly Father, we come before you with grateful hearts, with grateful, Lord Jesus, my God, voices, we sing to you these songs, because you have been so good. Señor, en este día, Señor, te cantamos, porque tú, Señor, has sido bueno. Tú eres, Señor, fiel, Señor, más fiel que el sol. Tú sí siempre, Señor, brillas tu misericordia, tu gracia sobre nosotros, día tras día tras día. Señor, tú estás aquí con nosotros y ahí también estás, Señor, en cada hogar de cada hermano que está mirando, Señor, ese servicio. Tú estás en todos los lugares, Señor. Tú estás, Señor, aleluya, listo a darnos, Señor, lo que nosotros necesitamos. Pero este día, Señor, necesitamos más que todo, Señor. Es tu presencia. Necesitamos más de tu respiro. Necesitamos más, Señor, de tu toque. Lord, we need more of your presence. We need your touch this morning. And so we ask you, Lord, that you would flow through, Lord, those that are singing, those that are playing, those that are ministering, and that you would flow, my God, into the homes and into the minds and into the souls and in, Lord Jesus, the hearts of all those that are watching, that you, your will would be done as always, and that we would be one with your will, that we would do your will, Lord, continually. In the name of Jesucristo, oramos. Amen. I'd like you to help us sing these songs as we render them to the Lord. Why don't you go ahead and sing there where you are at home as well. Fill up your homes with praise and worship. I believe that is our reasonable act of service this morning. Amen.
I see the King.
one more song. I know we usually only do one song, but we feel the need to continue to rejoice with you guys all. And we know that our Lord can change any situation, any environment. He can change you even more. So I'm going to ask you guys to move with me in the song. I'm trading my sorrows in the song.
Iglesia de Sion, paz de Cristo. En esta mañana damos toda la honra y la gloria a Dios por la vida, por el privilegio de ser hijos de Dios y por ustedes, una hermosa iglesia, preciosa, maravillosa. A esta hora quiero expresar mi gratitud, hermanos, por su ayuda que hemos recibido. No únicamente económicamente, sino también en las oraciones, en su positivismo. Cada vez que les llamo por teléfono, ustedes, hermanos, ustedes me inspiran, Porque siempre hablan de una manera positiva, de una manera, verdad, que me hace sentir bien y me dan ánimos. Y en esta situación estamos viendo que la iglesia está madurando. Este proceso está haciendo a la iglesia de Sion que madure, que se convierta en una congregación más espiritual, una congregación, verdad, que ora más, ayuna más, que lea más de la palabra de Dios. Y todo sea para la honra y la gloria. Hermanos, y esto va a resultar en un grande avivamiento para nuestra iglesia local. Al Señor sea la honra y la gloria por ello. Amén. En esta mañana quiero dejarles un pensamiento hablando, hermanos, de el enfoque que debe de haber nosotros hacia la meta. Y vamos a presentarles a ustedes lo que escribió Pablo a la iglesia en Filipos. En Filipenses 3, del 13 al 14, dice: hermanos, yo mismo no pretendo haberlo ya alcanzado, pero una cosa hago, olvidando ciertamente lo que queda atrás y extendiéndome a lo que está delante, prosigo a la meta, al premio del supremo llamamiento de Dios en Cristo Jesús. Hermanos, el llamamiento de Pablo fue muy peculiar, porque miramos en la historia, en el libro de Hechos, que Pablo, que era llamado Saulo, ¿verdad?, iba, hermanos, con unas intenciones macabras. Lo que él tenía en su corazón era de destruir a la iglesia en Damasco. Pero yendo hacia ese lugar, Dios lo llama de una manera, ¿verdad?, maravillosa. Y miramos que específicamente Dios le dice al discípulo Ananías que Pablo había sido llamado para que fuera un instrumento escogido. Es interesante cómo Dios lo llama cuando este hombre está en medio, hermanos, de lo malo. Pero Dios le dice a Ananías, ¿verdad?, de que Pablo había sido escogido para que llevase su nombre en presencia de los gentiles, los reyes y los israelitas. El llamamiento divino incluiría la necesidad de que este hombre debería de padecer y sufrir por el nombre de Jesucristo. Aún cuando Dios le dice, cuando el Señor Jesucristo le dice a Ananías que fuera a orar por Saulo de Tarso, Ananías, hermanos, tenía miedo, tenía temor, porque Ananías le dice al Señor: he oído cosas malas de este hombre. Pero el Señor le dice: ve y ora por Saulo, porque él ha visto en visión que llega el discípulo Ananías y ora por él. Ahora, el ministerio de Pablo fue un ministerio brillante y fructífero. Pero este hombre, hermanos, experimentó muchísimos sufrimientos por causa del evangelio. En la segunda carta a los Corintios, Pablo describe sus padecimientos y él dice: 5 veces fui azotado por los judíos, 3 veces azotado con varas, 1 vez apedreado, 3 veces en naufragios, en peligros de ríos, en peligros de ladrones, peligros en el desierto, peligros en el mar, peligros entre falsos hermanos, mucho trabajo, fatiga, desvelos, hambre, sed, desnudez, ayunos y la preocupación por las iglesias. Pero miramos que a pesar de todo esto, Pablo, hermano, se conserva firme y enfocado en la meta del premio. Absolutamente nada de este mundo iba a hacer que Pablo titubeara o que abandonara su jornada ni su servicio a Dios. ¿Qué miramos en Pablo? Miramos una tremenda firmeza, una persistencia, una perseverancia, constancia, paciencia y un compromiso total. En estos días, por lo que estamos atravesando, nunca más que antes en nosotros debe de haber el mismo sentimiento, lo mismo que sentía Pablo. En nosotros debe de haber, hermanos, un compromiso total, porque debemos estar enfocados hacia la meta del supremo llamamiento, el premio. Ahora, la palabra proseguir, cuando Pablo dice, yo prosigo a la meta, la palabra proseguir significa perseguir. En otras palabras, Pablo perseguía el premio. Esta palabra también significa esforzarse por algo de valor. Entonces Pablo está diciendo, yo he sufrido muchísimo por la causa de Cristo, pero eso ya quedó atrás. Yo ya me he olvidado de los sufrimientos y lo único que es importante para mí es extenderme hacia adelante y perseguir y lograr la meta del premio. Otra cosa que él dejaba atrás era el orgullo. Él, hermanos, Pablo se jactaba de su fariseísmo. Él se jactaba que había sido tutoreado, ¿verdad?, enseñado por Gamaliel, el gran judío eminente, doctor de la ley en Jerusalén. Él se jactaba, hermano, de ser de la tribu de Benjamín, hebreo de hebreos, fariseo, perseguidor de la iglesia por ser un fanático y un celoso de la ley. Pero todo eso estaba en el pasado. Eso ya ha pasado. Él se olvidaba de todo eso, porque ahora únicamente él estaba enfocado en el premio que el Señor Jesucristo le iba a dar. Nuestro Señor Jesucristo dijo, en el mundo tendréis aflicción, pero confiad, yo he vencido al mundo. Iglesia de Sion, la adversidad, los obstáculos, la oposición son parte, hermanos, del camino. Pero gracias a Dios que Él ha prometido estar con nosotros todos los días y multiplicar nuestras fuerzas. Tenemos que seguir adelante. Repito, tenemos que seguir adelante. Las cosas sin valor no requieren ningún esfuerzo, ni presentan dificultades. Lo que nosotros estamos buscando, lo que nosotros estamos, hermano, poniendo nuestros ojos de la fe, es el premio de la vida eterna. Y lo que el Señor Jesucristo nos va a dar es grandísimo, eterno, duradero e incomparable. Perdón, no hay nada en este mundo que tenga alguna comparación con lo que Dios nos va a dar. Repito, tenemos que seguir adelante. Como dice Romanos 8:18, pues tengo por cierto que las aflicciones del tiempo presente no son comparables con la gloria venidera que en nosotros ha de manifestarse. En otras palabras, no importa las aflicciones, no importa la escasez, no importa los problemas, las enfermedades, nada de eso es comparable con lo que Dios nos va a dar, hermanos, en la vida eterna. A estos momentos les invito, vamos a orar por todas las necesidades. Hay hermanos que están sin trabajar, vamos a orar por ellos. Hay hermanos enfermos. Y vamos a orar por toda la familia de Sion, de la hermosa iglesia de Sion. Vamos a orar, hermanos, por los enfermos que hay en todo el mundo. Y vamos a orar para que Dios, verdad, quite este virus, esta enfermedad, esta epidemia, hermanos, y que todo regrese a la normalidad. Todos los hermanos con los que he hablado me dicen, pastor, estoy ansioso de ir a través al templo, ¿verdad? Y creo que cuando regresemos vamos a tener un fiestón. Vamos a festejar la gloria de Dios, hermanos, y vamos a alabar a Dios como nunca antes lo hemos hecho. Pero esta hora les invito a hacer una oración. Señor Padre Santísimo, Jehová de los ejércitos, a esta hora venimos ante ti. Te damos gracias por tu palabra, que tu palabra nos da el aliento, nos da las fuerzas, nos da la fe, la convicción, la esperanza, Señor, de que nosotros algún día vamos a estar en la patria celestial. Y no importa por lo que estamos pasando, todo, Señor, la adversidad, los problemas en que nos encontramos, eso es pasajero, porque sabemos que tú vienes por nosotros y pronto estaremos en la patria celestial. Pero te pedimos por los hermanos que están sin trabajar, te pedimos por los hermanos, ¿verdad?, que tal vez estén enfermos. Aleluya, yo reprendo todo desánimo en el nombre del Señor Jesucristo. También te pedimos, Señor, por el gobierno. Aleluya, te pedimos por los enfermos que hay a través de todo este globo terrestre. Pero te pido, Señor, por cada miembro de la iglesia de Sion, que tú nos bendigas, que tú nos ayudes, que tú nos protejas, Señor, desde los niños hasta los varones, cada hogar, cada matrimonio, Señor, aleluya, las madres solteras, las viudas, por toda la hermosa iglesia de Sion. Síguela bendiciendo, síguenos ayudando, Señor, aleluya, y todo es para tu honra y tu gloria en el nombre del Señor Jesucristo. También queremos agradecer a todos los hermanos que participaron en las cadenas de oración. Not all the young people, I want to thank you. I'm proud of you if you prayed in this prayer chain. I thank you so much, hermanos. Sigamos adelante con la cabeza levantada, porque grande es el premio que el Señor nos va a dar.
Paz Cristo, hermanos. Qué hermoso mensaje nos ha traído el Señor Jesucristo por medio de su siervo. Y es cierto que en estos días hemos aprendido mucho, que nosotros, aunque el templo es hermoso, el edificio, sin el edificio podemos seguir adelante unidos, y se puede sentir la unidad ahorita, para mí más que nunca, cuando yo escucho sus testimonios, algunos hermanos que veo cada semana, pero también por medio de hermano Pastor Leobardo, ustedes ahorita están demostrando mucha fe, y eso me inspira también, eso me levanta. Y también, hermanos, hemos aprendido a hacer unas cosas por el internet, y muchas gracias a nuestros hermanos Caleb, Natalie, mi tía Patricia también. Y para mí algo muy hermoso es que ustedes siempre llegan a tiempo cuando tenemos esos servicios en el internet. Y eso es hermoso también. I love the fact that we've learned a lot to do a lot of things differently. I miss you all, but I do love that we've gone forward and that we've shown, God's shown us that although a temple, an office, or a building is beautiful to have, unity can be achieved even without having a building. And we have seen that. So thank you so much for showing your support. And I love the fact, too, that we've learned that we can move forward in the technology age. And we've been blessed to have Natalie and Caleb, my aunt Patty, and my sister Janelle has helped us as well to go forward in this new type of age that we're in now. And the other part that I mentioned that I love is that with our online service, everyone's always on time. I mean, look at you. You're right there. I'm right here. Beautiful. We're going to go ahead and get into the Word of God. And as we're doing that, we're going to turn to Hebrews chapter 10. As we're going to chapter 10, I want to thank all those that helped fast the last couple weeks in the youth prayer chain. I want to thank so much my cousin Natalie, cousin Caleb, Priscilla, Michelle, Kaylin, my sister Janelle, of course, Janie, Damaris. We also have, I believe, Crystal helped out, Jair, Rafa, and if I missed anyone else, and Eric as well. If I missed anyone else, I'm sorry. But for this week, I think we should try to do it again. So just be ready to go ahead and fast. Fast during the week and then pray on Saturdays, that prayer chain. Young men, I've noticed that we probably could have a few more of you. So if you're there with me in Hebrews chapter 10, we're going to speak today for just a few minutes about persevering in the new walk. Amen. Why don't you pray with me for just a moment? Heavenly Father, you are good. I thank you for this moment. I thank you for this word that you've given me and you've spoken to me, Lord. So, Lord Jesus, profoundly, my God, this week, and I ask, Lord, that you allow it to speak to all of us as well. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. You can go and take your seats. Awesome. All right, so we're going to start in chapter 10, verse 19. And it says, therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, that is, his body, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, and we're going to pause there. So what Paul is doing, and he does this through all of the book of Hebrews, as I've learned and I'm still learning because he's so deep, Paul presents a new way of worship to the Hebrews. And these were people that were entrenched in the way of the law. So now Paul is telling them, this is the way. This is the new way. So Paul is telling them no longer did they need to look to animal sacrifices. No longer did they need to look to old festivals, or no longer did they have to practice certain feasts. They didn't need those things because those things were inadequate, he says. They weren't adequate to do what Christ did. Through the blood of Christ, the new believer has been given a new covenant founded on grace. Can we say that again? It was founded and it is founded on grace. This new covenant saw the believer justified by grace. We are justified by the Lord's grace. And he tells them that they have been made new and they've been made holy by the blood of Christ. So I want to ask you today, have you been made perfect? Have you been forgiven? Have you been made new? Have you been washed by the blood of the Lamb? Or are you trying to constantly prove how good of a person you are? Maybe you haven't met Jesus Christ yet. Maybe you haven't yet given your life to God. But it can be really tiring, right? Trying to prove how good you are walking those people across the street and trying to help out and volunteering, and which is good. But maybe people try to do a lot of these things to prove how good they are. And Paul is saying in this book, you don't have to try to prove yourself to be holy because you can't do that. You can't prove yourself. You can't prove in yourself that you are holy. The only way you can become holy is by believing in the Lord Jesus Christ as your Father, as your Savior, and becoming reborn, by becoming a new creature. Doing good things is wonderful, but they do nothing for your debt of sin. And that's what Paul is trying to tell the Hebrews. Those old things that you practiced, they cannot bring you holiness. They cannot bring you a new way of life. Paul tells the Hebrews, without the payment of your sins, you will continue to live in darkness. Your old way of life will haunt you. But because of the blood of the Lamb, we can be purified. Our flesh, and he says, and our conscience can be washed and made new again. We can live and walk in grace, knowing that our Lord Jesus Christ is with us and in us everywhere we go. And Paul says, after the cross, Jesus has now become our high priest. How many of you guys know that he's not on the cross anymore? How many of you guys know that he's already gone through the pain? He's already bled. He's already worn that crown of thorns. He's no longer on the cross. He's no longer on the side of a building or in a portrait or on a necklace. But our Lord Jesus Christ is up in heaven and in our hearts. And he has become to us our high priest. And what does he do as our high priest? He intervenes for us perpetually. He intervenes in our weaknesses. And that's what Paul says. Our high priest knows our weaknesses. And he does not deal harshly with us. He doesn't look to spank us right away. He does discipline us, but he does so with love. And he shows us our imperfections. And he shows us that we can rest in him. He is our source of strength. And the Bible says, as Paul says, he explains, we have access to that place of holiness. We can speak confidently to him. He says we can boldly come before his throne of grace. And that's what he's inviting us to do in this next portion in verse 22 as we read forward. We go forward. Let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised us is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works. What Paul is saying here is that there is no more guilt, there is now joy. If you're a believer and you've been baptized and you've been reconciled to Christ, the sins that you committed before should not be haunting you because he's already forgiven you. The question is have you allowed him to heal those scars on the inside too? Because Paul's saying that we've been sprinkled by the blood of the Lamb. Even our conscience has. Now we need to trust in him. And the Bible says here, look what Paul says. He says we should hold fast the confession of our hope in verse 23 without wavering. For why? For he who promised us this is faithful. What does it mean to hold fast to something? It sounds awesome, right? And I thought I knew what it was and I had an idea of it. But hold fast means to remain tightly secured. That uses in the dictionary, it uses the example, the door held fast. It was locked. It was locked in. It's to continue to believe in or adhere to an idea or principle. It is important that we hold fast the policies, just like the restaurants are doing right now with their chairs all stacked one on another and having certain areas roped off. They're holding fast their policies, right? They're locked in their policies. Well, the Apostle Paul is saying that we have to be locked into Jesus. So how do we do that in the new walk? Well, what is a method of staying locked in? Well, the Bible says, and Paul mentions, that we should pray consistently, not just in your room, not just in the service, not just a shout, but maybe you worship him with a whisper on your way to work. Maybe you also worship him with your hands lifted high in the office. Maybe you do things in a new way. Yes, you can worship him in your room. Yes, you can worship him in the service. But maybe we should try worshiping him in all ways, in all the ways that we walk. We should worship the Lord. We can worship him when we're out walking on our own, on the run. Worship him under the sun. Worship him at noon. Worship him under the moon. God bless you, Brother Dr. Seuss. But we should worship him in real time. Worship him wherever we are. Worship him if we're near or far. Worship the Lord at all times. Isn't he worthy of that? Can't we do that? Can't we worship him everywhere we are and in everything that we are doing? That's why Paul says we should boldly come before him. It isn't a situation where we have to make an appointment with Jesus. Jesus is available to you right there where you're sitting, right there where you're watching, right there where you are. Jesus is available to you. And he says here in verse 24 and 25, it says, and let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. And he says here that we should live a life that pursues faithfulness. Amen. We are constantly pursuing to be fit, we're pursuing the goal to be faithful to the Lord. And he says we should show concern and affection for one another. It's good to think certain things about my brother or sister, but we need to step out and show that we're concerned. When's the last time that you spoke with that brother or sister? When's the last time you let them know that you were praying for them? When was the last time that you reached out and called them? When was the last time you connected with your brethren? I believe that God has not called us to be islands floating on our own in the lonely waters of life, but God has called us to come together with one another and to be united as one body, as one voice, as one people. It is not a time for us to forget about our brothers and sisters. And he says here that we should stir up in each other good acts. And what does it mean to stir up? But if any of you guys have baked before, and any of you sisters have, when you stir something up, what is the reason you stir it up? Well, in the most basic way that I can see, you stir something, you invest your energy in something that mixes two different things together. My wife taught me to make her cookies, and I'm not quite her level yet, but you get the flour, the egg, the sugar, and if you want to use a little bit of wheat too, you can put it in there with chocolate chips, and you just stir it up, and you bring it all together. Right? And I think that's the way it is in the walk of the Lord. God has brought so many different brothers and sisters from different walks and different backgrounds. And he finds a way to stir up all the wonderful gifts he's given us so we can come together. Brothers and sisters, let's stir up gifts and stir up good works within ourselves. The Holy Spirit inside of us is looking to mix things up. He's looking to cause us to do things in a new way. God wants us to walk in the new way, in his new life. God wants us to persevere in every environment and every time. And the Word of God says that we should not forsake the coming together with the brethren. And some of you may not, some of the brothers and sisters may not be able to watch us today, but those of you guys that are watching us, we need to continue coming together any way that we can. And if that means that we need to pray on a Saturday night in a prayer chain or fast during the week or read the Word of God together or do a Zoom session together or do a virtual service together, we need to be together. We're a family, and a family finds a way to always come together. And that's what we are doing today. God wants us to come together. We have to keep on encouraging one another as the time of our redemption comes closer. We are getting closer to the finish line. And if any of you guys have ever seen a race, at the end of a race, people begin to get louder and louder for one another. They hold up signs. They will tell you, you got this. Keep on going. You're going to make it just a little while longer. And as you get closer to the finish line, you don't stop moving. You keep on moving forward. It's a little tiring, I know. It's a little exhausting, I know. But you keep on moving forward. And right now, with everything that's going on around us, we know that the Lord is coming. It's very, very close. So keep on going, brothers and sisters. Grab of each other's hand in prayer. Grab a hold of another person in fasting and say, we're going to move forward in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to make it. Now's not the time to get relaxed. Now's not the time to sit down. Now's not the time to continue to sleep in because you have nothing else to do. Now's the time to get into the Word so the Word can get into you. We have to persevere in our new walk. Amen. Let's pray for all of the church right now and all of our friends, those of you that are watching. Maybe even if you're not watching, we're going to pray. Why don't you go ahead and close your eyes and bow your heads with me, because we are going to persevere. We're going to make it. Amen. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we pray for our brothers and sisters in Christ that are here, that are in other places, Lord, watching this. Maybe people, Lord, that are working, that weren't able to watch this service. People, Lord, perhaps that haven't even been baptized yet. We pray for them as well. We ask, my God, that you allow us to walk in newness and to walk in your life, to walk, my God, with a confidence that we always have access to you, knowing, my Father, Lord Jesus, that we are going to make it and that we are going to work through this and that the finish line, my God, is just a little while ahead and we are going to make it because you are with us. Lord, may we wake up feeling refreshed every morning and may we give you the honor and the glory. May we give you all that we have and may we be refreshed, my God, as we continue running the race. I pray for my brothers and sisters, my God, that have been a little bit tired, a little exhausted, a little down, a little anxious, a little depressed, a little sad. I ask you, my God, you refresh their spirit with joy and with liberty, and Lord God, with peace. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Once again, it's an enormous privilege for me to be here and to be able to experience God's presence. Para mí, hermanos, es un grande privilegio para poder escuchar la palabra de Dios y sentir su presencia. I think it's an amazing thing that in a world where people don't know where to go, and they don't know what to do, and they don't know what path to take, We know it wasn't Walt Disney that said, keep on moving forward. But what we've heard from the Lord today is that Jesus is the way forward. The Word of God says, as for God, His way is perfect. And it says, God makes my way perfect. La palabra de Dios nos habla a nosotros. Dice, en cuanto a Dios, perfecto es su camino. Luego la palabra de Dios dice, hace perfecto mi camino. Entonces, en este mundo donde las personas no saben dónde ir, nosotros tenemos nuestra esperanza en Cristo Jesús. ¿Dónde vamos a andar? Vamos a andar adelante. Vamos a andar adelante en victoria. We're going to keep on moving forward in the powerful name of Jesus. He is our victory. Amen. And so we are just comforted and we are reassured. Hemos recibido consuelo hoy de la palabra de Dios. This last week, my son Luke, he received a project, and the project was to write an essay about who you would like to invite over to your home. Esta semana pasada, mi hijo Luca recibió una tarea. Él tenía que escribir quién invitar a su casa. Whenever you turn on this program, whenever you get into the Word, whenever you get into the Spirit, you are inviting Jesus into your home. Cuando nosotros, hermanos, participamos en adoración, estamos mirando este programa, este servicio, estamos invitando al Señor en nuestro hogar. Pero hoy es el día más que nunca. Today is a day more than ever before for us to be in one accord in fasting and prayer. Como nunca más antes, tenemos que estar unidos en oración y en ayuno. Entonces, es el deseo del Señor, expresado por nuestro pastor, que cada familia que nosotros podemos unirnos todos los días y oremos, hermanos, en nuestras salas, en nuestras recámaras, con nuestros hijos, y leer algo de la escritura de la palabra de Dios. More than ever, let's fast, let's pray, let's come together with our families every single day, amen, and have a share the word and share a time of prayer. We would also like to invest, ask everyone to fast one day this week. Todos los hermanos estamos invitando al pastor que nosotros ayunemos por lo menos un día esta semana. Fellowship isn't necessarily being together in one physical place, but fellowship is taking part of that same spirit, that same eternal spirit of Jesus Christ. La unión y comunión no es estar unidos físicamente, pero unidos en ese hermoso Espíritu Santo. We are thankful again for everybody who is giving. Damos gracias a Dios para todos los hermanos que están dando a la obra del Señor. Y que, we want to just encourage you to begin to continue to give with all of your heart. Queremos dar, hermanos, a cada uno de ustedes, exhortarles, seguir dando con todo su corazón. Hay necesidad, pero el Señor es fiel. God is always faithful. Amen. And we just want to also be encouraged by what we see before us, because we know that every single day, the Bible says that we are closer and closer to the day where He's going to come for us. Estamos, hermanos, bajo de gozo, sabiendo que el Señor, cuando Él viene, es más cerca que ayer. I want to invite you to close your eyes with me today. Quiero invitar a cada uno de ustedes, hermanos, que cierren sus ojos conmigo. Levanten las manos ahí donde están. Right there where you are, lift up your hands. Let's come before the Lord. Lord Jesus, we come before you. Señor Jesucristo, una vez más, acercamos, Señor, a tu trono, a tus pies, dando a ti, Señor, toda la honra y toda la gloria. Giving you, Lord Jesus, all praise and honor and glory. Porque tú, Señor, tú eres Alfa y Omega. You are the beginning and the end. Tú, oh, Señor, eres el Todopoderoso. Tú, oh Señor, que estás en control de todas las cosas. Tú, oh Señor, que das fuerza y fortaleza y paz y gozo a tu pueblo para seguir adelante. Lord Jesus, you are the all-powerful God that gives us strength and joy and peace that we may continue moving forward as we march forward, oh God. Hallelujah, in that perfect way that you present, that you make clear en ese camino perfecto, Señor. Te damos gracias, Señor. Tú que nos has sanado. Tú que nos has salvado. We thank you, Jesus, the one who has saved us and the one that has healed us. Presentamos a esta hermosa congregación. Oh, Señor, esté con cada varón, con cada Dorca, con cada joven, con cada junior, Lord, that you would be with every member of our church. Hallelujah, que tú lo, Señor, levante, Señor. Hallelujah, la mirada adelante y arriba. Hallelujah, porque el socorro viene de Jehová. Oh, our help comes from the Lord, and we are thankful, God, for your presence. Gracias, Señor, por tu presencia. En el poderoso nombre de Cristo Jesús. Amen, amen. Many blessings to you, and we're going to keep on moving forward in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.